Rolando Romero, just got to the gym. What a coincidence. We happen to catch you out here.
Man, I'm very
So what do you think about Charlo Castaño, the rematch? Charlo has 3 belts, Castaño has 1 belt. First fight was close.
I think it's going to be a great fight. I think Charlo is going to make some adjustments. And he's, like I said, that's another, you know, it was a good fight. It was a really good fight, you know? So I really don't know. I think Charlo's going to come in a little bit better this fight around. But like I said, I heard Castaño's training really hard, so who knows?
So you're going to see Tank in the next coming days. You guys are going to face off. What are we going to see when that happens, you know?
Face off?
A press conference, just promotion.
Yeah, face off. No big, nothing special, just face off.
May 28th, one of the biggest fights this year. You're excited? Everybody's excited?
Yeah.
What do you tell Tank if he's watching? You obviously studied him, right? You've been studying him?
Not really.
No,
I
why
mean,
not?
I've seen damn near all his fights, you know?
You never sparred him, right?
Never. We're supposed to spar his.
But it's a big fight. What can fans expect?
Rolly to knock him out really, really bad. Like, really, really bad. Like, really, 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 really bad.
What are the odds right now in Vegas? How do the odds makers have it, you know?
He's a favorite, 6-1.
That's a big difference, big gap, 6-1.
Yeah.
What do you think about that?
Hey, bet everyone go to Circus Sports. Right now, go to Circus Sports. Bet everything you got on me. I'm going to knock Tank out, and we all going to get rich. Okay?
6-1. That means you probably have to bet 600 on Tank to win, right? And on you bet 100 to win 600, right? Do you bet a lot? Are you good in sports betting or you don't
play? I bet on boxing. I don't really.
Do you win?
Yeah. I mean, it's not too, like, boxing is very, the thing with boxing is not good to bet on sports. I'm not on it unless, like, you're in and you know what a real underdog is, you know? So, like, with boxing, right, they have usually the favorite as a heavy favorite. So, it's like you have to bet $3,000 to win $300, you know?
Yeah.
So, it's like, boxing's not good to make money as far as betting, you know? Now, with other sports, I don't watch other sports, so I don't really know. I don't even watch boxing, really.
So, Rolly, hypothetically, if you could go back in time and fight one legend from back in the day, who would you fight?
Roberto Duran, I'd go get my ass beat by Roberto Duran.
You think so?
Yeah.
Mike.
Roberto Duran.
Him against Roberto Duran. What do you think? 135.
Me?
No, Rolly. Who knocks who out? He would knock Roberto Duran out? Why do you say that?
He's going to catch him.
That's a big compliment.
He can punch. He's going to catch him.
Damn, bro. Hey, I'm going to tell you like that. Roberto Duran is scary.
He was a monster.
Yeah. I mean, that's a dude, man. At 135, yes. Roberto Duran, monster.
Bad man. Bad man.
That one. He's still.
In all the days.
Hey, Casamayor. What do you think? Let me see. Rolly against Roberto Duran. What do you think about that fight?
In all the days. Duran, old age, young, old age.
No, I 135 pounds. 135 pounds. Prime Duran.
Tell him. Duran.
Por qué?
Who go win? Him or Duran?
He picked Duran.
You picked Duran?
Duran, man. I'll be honest, man.
Duran, man.
Duran, the legend, man.
Yeah, the legend.
Fuck
that.
Duran will fuck me up.
He says that's a, that's how you beat him. That's funny, but you have your Hall of Famer saying you would beat Duran. That's a big compliment.
I'm playing, man. That's a hard one, man. That's a really hard one, man. But you know what? I can't really have an opinion whether I beat Duran or not because it's not my era.
Yeah, you're right. Different styles.
And I'm not gonna disrespect a legend saying I fuck up Duran. You know,
that's true. But
like I said, that's a very best inside fighter of all time. I give two fucks what anyone says.
Okay, so Loma is available. Let's say everything happens good in his country. Who should he fight next? Because obviously Devin and Kambosos have like a two fight deal, right? I think it's a 2 or 3 fight deal.
Loma.
Him and Ryan, do you like it if Ryan beats Emmanuel to go?
I think Ryan can get a more exciting fight than Lomachenko. I think Ryan can get a way better fight than Lomachenko.
Like who? Josh Taylor at 40?
Jojo Diaz.
That's more exciting than Loma?
I think that'd be a better, like, more competitive fight, you know? I think that would be because, I don't know, like, watching Loma fight kind of puts me to sleep. So, it, you know, like I said, I think of, like, if you want to keep, like, the, like, if you want to keep building Ryan and making him, like, you know, spectacular regardless of everything, you want to be with him with, let's say, for instance, like a Jojo Diaz or someone like that, you know? You don't want to put him in there with some dude that's honestly, if he gets scared, he's just going to run around the ring the entire damn time, you know? Like what happened with Teal.
How's Teal doing, by the way?
He's doing good. He's doing good. I haven't talked to him really in like 3 weeks or so, you know? He's been moving around a bit.
He had surgery. He's having another surgery. I wish him the best. He's a good dude.
Yeah, I think it's been about a month since I've really seen him, you know?